Going green is all the rage. Electric cars, solar panels, power walls, renewable energy. But does green energy really make a difference to you? Does it improve your life in some way and actually save the planet? Does it even make sense on a simple, everyday, practical level? The answer may surprise you. In this video, we'll answer the question, is green energy really green or is it a bunch of brown stuff? Let's start with solar power. Unless you've been living under a rock, you surely haven't missed all the endless ads for solar panels and battery banks and so on. Free power from the sun. I mean, that's great, right? Why not? Well, first of all, you have to actually manufacture thousands and thousands, tens of hundreds of thousands of solar panels. And that requires a whole lot of material and energy. Second, solar panels do actually fail. And since they're made primarily of glass, but also a bunch of heavy metals, that's kind of a problem when it comes time to get rid of them. But as of 2021, Forbes notes, by 2035, there will be 2.5 times more discarded panels than new ones. Recycling isn't that viable. Nobody does it because solar panels consist of mostly glass, so it's cheaper to just chuck them into landfills. Mostly landfills in other countries. And what about those tax credits, or even free panels from the government? Well, they're not really free. Any money you get from the government comes from, guess what, taxes. So if you haven't paid for those solar panels yet, you will, in the form of higher taxes, increased fuel prices, general inflation. You don't get something for nothing. Speaking of waste, what about wind farms? Wind blows, wind turbines turn, free electricity. Boom, you're done, right? What could be better than that? Well, let's start with the same waste problem. In 20 years, many experts are predicting that in the US alone, there will be over 720,000 tons of used wind turbine blades in US landfills. Oops! Plus, wind farms work based on the wind blowing. What happens if the wind doesn't blow? Well, actually, that's exactly what did happen in the UK back in 2010. 13 years ago, during a cold snap in the UK, the wind didn't blow. So they ended up getting 25 times less electricity from wind farms than they expected. Again, oops! Note that they were also worried way back then that perhaps relying too much on wind was a bad idea. But they carried on anyway. Also, thousands of giant spinning blades have an unfortunate habit of chopping up birds in flight. No big deal. Well, fine, but certainly geothermal power is a win-win, right? In Croatia, for example, they recently discovered this giant underground reservoir of hot water and they want to turn it into a geothermal power plant. This super hot underground lake might produce up to 16 megawatts of electricity. So what's the problem? Well, the lake is 2.4 kilometers down inside the earth. You need to drill down to get to the hot water, but you don't always get it right on the first try, so you have to drill hole after hole after hole and hope that it works. Drilling multiple 2.4 kilometer deep holes, as you might imagine, costs a whole lot of money and requires a whole lot of energy and time. So it's not so easy. Plus, 16 megawatts, as we'll see, is not really a whole lot of power. Speaking of power output, like, is there a solution? Well, some countries are going less green and actually investing in nuclear power plants. China, for example, just opened a brand new shiny fourth generation special nuclear reactor, and they're actually working on fifth generation nuclear reactors, which are pretty fancy. More on that in another video soon. But why would you go nuclear when you could go green? It's all about the power. First, if we're talking about solar panels, in order to produce enough energy for the entire globe, you'd need to cover the country of France entirely in solar panels. 2 or 3 times over, because the sun doesn't shine all the time, and better safe than sorry. That's a lot of solar panels. Well, but what about wind power? Well, if we assume that a large, modern wind turbine produces 2.5 megawatts, and we assume that a modern nuclear power plant produces a maximum of 1,000 megawatts, that means to produce the same power as one modern nuclear power plant, it would take 400 wind turbines. That's a lot of wind turbines. But what about geothermal? If we compare geothermal power plants and nuclear power plants, it would take 62 geothermal plants of the kind that they're going to develop in Croatia to equal one modern nuclear power plant. Okay, now at this point you're going, Scotty, right, but you forgot hydropower. I mean, surely hydropower is great. You dam up some water, the water flows, turns a generator, boom, free electricity. You can't go wrong. What could possibly be wrong with hydropower? Right. It just so happens that in poorer countries, they are building hydroelectric power plants by the dozen. But in richer countries, we seem to actually be tearing them all down. Why is that? Well, to preserve natural habitats, resolve disputes involving people who were moved as a result of building the dams and flooding areas, and because somehow the giant water reservoirs for hydropower apparently produce large quantities of methane. This fascinating study shows the three different reasons why reservoirs and dams actually produce greenhouse gases. And the long and the short of it is that while Mother Nature knows what she's doing when she creates a large body of water, because everything is in a nice equilibrium, when humankind decides to make a giant artificial lake, we tend to mess it up, and bacterial microbe balances get out of whack, and it's kind of a disaster. So, yeah, even hydropower produces greenhouse gases. Who knew? But here's the real kicker. In addition to going green, you are also constantly told that the climate is changing, right? Climate change, climate change, climate change. Whether you believe that the Earth is heating up or cooling down, it doesn't matter. Everyone knows that climate change is here, and it's real, and it's here to stay. Okay, so if climate change is here, that means that literally the climate is changing. So why on earth would you invest in power generation that requires the sun to shine, or the wind to blow, or rivers flowing, or hot water bubbling up from the ground? Climate change means any and even all of those things could change, and that means suddenly you have no energy. And of course, you've shut down your coal plants and your nuclear plants, and you're not burning any fossil fuels, so... Hello? The safest is probably geothermal power, but it's also one of the most expensive to get up and running in the first place. And it may not be so great after all. Iceland, which has geothermal power plants, recently had a giant crack open up in the ground due to volcanic activity. So, yeah, geothermal power, maybe not. It's not that green energy is a bad idea. It's a great idea. I mean, who doesn't want free energy? But as we've seen, it's not really free. And the second problem is the way that our governments and corporations have been pushing green energy against all logic, reason, and simple common sense. The reality is that without vast changes in the way we do just about everything, we aren't going to switch over to green energy in 5 minutes, or even 5 years. Possibly not even in 5 decades. So if you want to go green, knock yourself out. Just know what you're actually getting yourself into. For more information on why we can't just ditch fossil fuels completely, for example, you can watch my earlier video, What Happens If We Ditch Fossil Fuels? And let me know in the comments below if you have an exciting story about going green. For more techie tips, see ScottiesTech.info. Thanks for watching. See you next time.